Hello everyone, Derek Johnson with Tatango.com. Today I'm answering the question, is RCS messaging encrypted? Yes, RCS messaging is encrypted. So why are so many people online so confused? They're arguing about encryption for RCS messaging. Well, what they're arguing is RCS messaging is encrypted, but it's not end-to-end encrypted. So let me explain for the people that don't know what I'm talking about. Encryption in kind of the most simple form, especially in messaging, means that if I message you something and it comes from my phone, the people in the middle cannot readily access that information. They can't read our messages. Now, there are people with keys. You have a key, I have a key. So when it lands on my phone, I unencrypt the message and then you unencrypt the message so you can see it. Now, in things like RCS messaging, the carriers or people in the middle also have a key. Now, those messages aren't unencrypted all the time, but if legally required, the carriers would have to unencrypt a message and see what the content is. That's what people are arguing about, because nowadays, especially outside the United States, there's a lot of messaging apps that are end-to-end encrypted, which means there's nobody in the middle that has a key. So even if the government wants to see a message, they cannot request the message because no one in the middle has a key. Examples are Telegram, WhatsApp, even the one funded or started by Mark Cuban, the guy from Shark Tank, Dust or Cyberdust, I think that was what it used to be called. They are end-to-end encrypted. So that means if, let's say, a government wanted to see what the message was between you and me, and I was using something like Dust or Telegram or WhatsApp, there's nobody at those companies that has a key that can unencrypt our messages between each other. Now, on the RCS side, there are people that have the key. So, RCS messaging, definitely encrypted. It is encrypted as it goes along, which is great for businesses because it means that the information, let's say you're sending two-factor authentication, let's say you're sending private information like health records, let's say you're sending bank information, the information is encrypted. So people that get access to it, they can't actually see it without encrypting the message. Now, the only people that have the encryption are certain people like the wireless carriers. They would have to be legally required to essentially unencrypt a message and see what is in there. I doubt that's going to be happening much with business messaging. But for P2P messaging, that's where the confusion is coming. RCS messaging is encrypted, but it's not end-to-end encrypted, which means the government can really essentially, if it legally done, can unencrypt the message or request the message to be unencrypted, and there is somebody in the middle that can actually unencrypt the message. On end-to-end encryption, like WhatsApp, like Dust, like Telegram, no one has that encryption key, so the message, it only goes to you and me, and that's all. So, hopefully that answers the question, is RCS encrypted? Yes, 100%. It is encrypted. There's no argument about that. Is it end-to-end encrypted? No, that's not correct because the carriers, people in the middle, do have the access key that, if legally required, can gain access to those messages. So again, it's not end-to-end encrypted, but it is encrypted. Hopefully that clears it up. Let me know if you're still confused in the comments below. But again, my name is Derek Johnson with Tatango.com, and I've just answered the question, is RCS messaging encrypted? Yes, it is, but it's not end-to-end encrypted.